Have you ever turned on a faucet in your home and wondered where that water comes from? Or watched it go down the drain and pondered where it may end up? Today, we are going to talk about water and explore how it gets to your tap and where it drains if you live in the Hudson River Valley. You probably know that sinks and showers are connected to pipes that carry water through your home. But before that water reaches your faucet, it needs to come from a source. Source water is any water body from which water can be used for drinking or cooking. Source water is drawn from either surface water, such as lakes, streams, rivers, or reservoirs, or groundwater, which collects underground, below your feet, in the spaces between the sand, sediments, and rock formations. First, let's talk about surface water, which is stored on the land's surface in water bodies. It can be funny to think about, but surface water can come from just a few drops of rain. As waters accumulate in areas and begin to flow, they become streams, and as they continue to gain water through more precipitation, they become larger streams or rivers. Surface water is the primary source of water for many people. One way for us to use streams and rivers as source water is to construct a dam on a stream or a river that will stop and store the water in a reservoir that can then be sent to communities. One example of a surface water supply in the Hudson Valley is the Ashokan Reservoir, where I am now. This is fed by streams and runoff from the Catskill Mountains. From here, it is connected to the Catskill Aqueduct System, which is a vast network of underground tunnels and pipes that carry water 125 miles south of here to New York City and other communities along its path. The majority of people who live in the Hudson River Valley live in villages or cities, and the drinking water coming out of their taps is most often provided by a public water system, commonly managed by a water department or a private water company, which tests for water purity. Here, we are at the Village of New Paltz Water Filtration Facility, where its source water comes from a variety of places, including the Catskill Aqueduct, which we saw earlier, and four other reservoirs located nearby, fed by surface water streams and groundwater supplies. Regardless of where the water comes from, if it's from a surface or groundwater supply, source water requires some treatment before it reaches our tap. Water treatment plants like this one take several steps to treat water, including filtration and chlorination. At every stage of the process, water goes through a series of tests to ensure it's safe for human drinking. Once it meets the standards, it is sent out through pipes to everyone who is served by the water supply system. Here we are at the Hudson River in Poughkeepsie. The Hudson River is a surface water supply, which is the primary source of drinking water for over 100,000 people between Poughkeepsie and communities to the north. Communities south of Poughkeepsie do not get their drinking water from the Hudson because the Hudson River is an estuary that has tides that bring salt water upstream. Here is a groundwater model to give us a better sense about how water moves through the landscape. The way water gets into the ground is by rain or snow percolating into the soil until it hits a rock or clay layer at the bottom. That's when the water stops and sits between the spaces in the soil. Water collects and is stored in those spaces, forming what we call an aquifer. An aquifer is an underground layer of permeable rock, such as sand or gravel, where water can easily collect. People access groundwater by drilling wells into the aquifer. Basically, you dig a long, narrow hole with a long tube into the ground that reaches into the earth. It kind of acts like a big straw. Groundwater wells can be shallow, say 20 feet deep, or as deep as hundreds of feet below the surface. Once you dig deep enough, you'll hit water that is trapped and slowly flowing beneath the ground at the level where the soil is saturated. That is what is called the water table. Some towns and cities have many wells that they use to pull large amounts of water out of the ground at once. Then water is sent to people who need it through pipes. Or a home can have a private well to service just one home. About 10% of people in the Hudson Valley get their water from a private well. You may have noticed wellheads that look like this, which indicate the location of groundwater wells. If you are not connected to a local sewer system, then your home's wastewater is discharged into a septic system. This means that wastewater generated by your home goes into an underground tank with underground pipes, which slowly disperse the water back on site, where it is filtered through the soil rather than being collected and transported to a wastewater treatment plant far away. If you're living in a more densely populated city or village, it's likely that the water going down your drain every time you flush a toilet or take a shower is connected to a network of pipes that move wastewater from smaller to larger pipes until it reaches a wastewater treatment plant like this one. All the water from thousands of homes and businesses is collected, treated, and discharged into a river. The water that we drink and leaves our homes as wastewater is all part of the water cycle. It is important to protect source water by protecting watersheds, forests, wetlands, and landscapes from contamination. Forests, in particular, help to keep our water sources clean and plentiful, so many reservoirs like this one are surrounded by many acres of forest. It's also important to be mindful of what is being flushed or washed down the drain or dumped onto the ground, because ultimately chemicals and other pollutants will end up in our water supply and negatively impact the ecological health of the Hudson River Estuary and its watershed, a place that we all love. You can learn more about who provides your drinking water in your community and find out the annual drinking water quality report on the following websites. Thanks for joining us.